Hey, what is up, everyone? Welcome back to another tutorial video! I'm kidding. This is not how I speak. So before we start, this would be another one of those experimental video where I'll do something different. So this time I decided to speak to you guys instead of the usual, you know, the text overlay with relaxing music. Right, music. Hold on. With that said, I hope I don't piss off too many of you guys with my voice. So with that out of the way, right, so in this video I'm gonna talk a little bit about panel lining. Now I do understand that there are plenty of good and bad tutorials out there for this same topic, but I don't think there's a lot of them that demonstrates the pros and cons of different methods. So in this video, I'm gonna show three methods that I've used personally, and I'll be showing you guys which I personally prefer. I'll also be talking about a different type of cleaning swab that I use to clean up excess paint. It's sort of different than the conventional cotton, but I'll talk a little bit about that near the end of the video. So the first method, which I personally believe is the easiest and the most accessible way to improve the overall look of your kit. It's affordable and each bottle lasts pretty long. Honestly, this is the same bottle that I've bought I think 2 years ago. Well, it lasted me this long maybe because I worked too slow. This came included with a brush attached to the cap, so I think it's really convenient so that you don't have to buy additional brush when you're just starting out in the hobby. All you need to do is to dab the brush on the lines and it'll flow along the line smoothly. However, the drawback of this is the amount of cleaning up that you need to do. Depending on the finish of your paint job, if it's too rough, the paint may not flow as well and you may end up applying more along the lines. So this will add up to the amount of cleaning up that you need to do in the end. But would I recommend this? Yeah, definitely. It's readily available and they last a long time. Now let's go into the second method, which is the fountain pen method. I've got this pen not too long ago, and it was actually my first time using this type of pen. It's not really expensive, it cost me just a couple of bucks, and it's supposed to be the superior application method compared to the Tamiya brush, which I kinda agree. So the tip of the pen is really sharp, and when I got it to work as intended, it really does require way less cleaning up compared to the Tamiya brush. However, I noticed a potential flaw. See, on the RX78 workout kit that I completed recently. And by the way, the video link is on the top right if you're interested. So I added a lot of custom panel line scribings on the RX78 workout kit, and most of them were done with the 0.15mm scriber. So when I was using the pen to sort of poke the lines, you know, in order to get the paint to flow into the lines, but I found out that it left a mark on the lines. So the tip of the pen itself is actually thicker than the 0.15mm lines, so it essentially damaged some lines on the kit. I'm actually not sure if I'm the only one having this issue, as I'm pretty heavy-handed. I could be using too much strength when I was trying to apply paint on the panel lines. Well, that could be the cause, yeah. If you are using something similar, let me know in the comment section if this have happened to you before. Last but not least, it's the airbrush method. The first time I saw someone doing this was on Janik's video. So this is particularly useful if some panel lines are too wide to fill with conventional methods. So for the airbrush method, I actually mix my own enamel dark gray paint to get a tone that I actually prefer. So the idea is to airbrush enamel paint and fill up the panel lines evenly, then clean up the excess like you normally would. Yeah, it is basically reverse washing with enamel. One thing to note is that if the surface of your kit or your paint job is too rough, then there's a lot of uneven gaps on the surface which will make it really difficult to clean up. This could potentially stain the area, which could actually destroy the paint job of your kit. There's a way to minimize this problem from happening. In fact, I think you should do this anyway. I'm talking about gloss top coating. The gloss coat allows the paint to flow smoothly, and the smooth surface will make it really easy to clean up. There are other benefits of gloss top coating. By doing this, it will form a protective layer which will protect your kit from being damaged by enamel paint. So again, depending on your paint job, if it's too rough or uneven when you're applying decals, it can be too rough for you to shift the decals around. So overall, I think you should absolutely top coat your kit before applying panel lines or decals. I mean, it's a no-brainer. It provides like a smoother finish, even if it's like a matte top coat in the end. Right, so previously I've mentioned that I'm using something different to clean up the excess paint. You've probably noticed these weird looking cotton buds that I'm using. So these are actually sensor cleaners. I think people use it to clean their camera sensors, but the one that I've got, they are labeled as cleaner sensor cleaners. Personally, I think these are much easier to work with. It doesn't break down easily and leave a lot of lint like the common cotton bud. I find them quite affordable and I'll probably use them exclusively for cleanups moving forward. And by the way, if you're interested in any of these products, the links are in the description. You know, I get a small commission if you buy something with my links, but it's really at no extra cost to you guys. I also noticed that a lot of my viewers are not subscribers. So if you like this video or the contents that I create, please consider subscribing. So YouTube will finally decide to push content from a small channel like mine to more people. If you would like to support the channel directly, please check out my Patreon link, or you can also buy me a coffee so that I can work faster. There you have it, all three methods of panel lining. To be honest, I'll continue using all three methods, but it depends on the design of the kit and the amount of panel lines on the area. I'm actually not sure if there are any other methods out there that's better or more convenient. Let me know if there's more methods out there that I'm not aware of, and which method do you use the most? Let me know in the comment section below. Alright, that's it guys. Thank you for watching and stay safe everyone.